With me is the head coach of Evanston, Herb Williams. And ladies and gentlemen, this gentleman is the first person ever to set foot on this floor as a basketball player in the state final when he played for Centralia. He's now here as a coach. Congratulations.
Well, thanks a lot. It's a lot of pride goes in this building, and, you know, it's just marvelous to be back here in this situation.
Tell us a little bit about the Evanston team we'll see today.
Well, we're a very balanced ball club. We play anywhere from 10 to 11 guys a ball game. We just keep coming at you. Back our second unit probably could have started for us any year. Individually wise, of course, we have Everett Stevens, who's a tremendous ball player. Lewis Wolf, Steve Kling, Derek Brown, and Tony Mason. And the thing about it, they play well together. And, you know, they look for each other, and they know how to play it.
Well, congratulations on getting here, Coach, and all the best of luck to you in the tournament.
Well, thank you very much.
That's Herb Williams, the head basketball coach at Evanston and former great star at Centralia High School. And now we're going to step in with the head basketball coach at Benton, Rich Heron. And, Rich, congratulations on your team being here.
Well, thank you, Frank. We're very happy to be here. We got great support, and we're playing real fine basketball right now.
You came really on strong at the end of the season.
Yes. We played well all year long, but we've gotten beaten by two fine teams, Carmdale and McLeansboro, but we're playing extremely great basketball, and we just hope we continue for about three more, and we'd be very happy.
What do you think the key to this game is? You're up against an undefeated team.
Well, we feel the pressure's on them. We're very relaxed, and I think the key, we got to handle their pressure defense. The other thing, we got to stop their break, and I think we can go inside and we can handle their pressure defense and get the ball down in the half court and make them play a half court game with it. I think we win the ball game.
When you have to have a basket, who are you going to go to?
Well, there's no doubt about it. Baker's the guy that gets the basket to us. But we got balance. House has come on extremely well late in the year. And Nuremberg's a fine point guard. Our big sophomore, Shaver, played well. And Peter's a fine player. We're a good balanced basketball team, but Baker's a big gun.
It never gets old, does it? You've been at it 24 years. I can tell how excited you are.
Well, I'm very emotional, you know, and we're very excited to be here. You know, we're just going to make a great show. And we're the only team left in Southern Illinois, south of Champaign. So we got one thing going for us. We're the best AA team. McLeansboro got it. We hope we bring another one back to Southern Illinois.
Congratulations.
Thank you, Frank.
Rich Heron, the head coach of Benton. Now let's go to Art Kimball.
Thank you very much, Frank. And we're just about set for the opening game in the quarterfinal round of the state AA tournament here at the Assembly Hall in Champaign. As you can hear, the enthusiasm is very, very definitely building. We're just about set for the presentation of colors and then, of course, the introduction of the starting lineup. And so now for the initial portion of our pregame ceremony, let's turn for the presentation of colors and then, of course, following the playing of our national anthem, the voice of the Assembly Hall, Tom Trent.
Ladies and gentlemen, after the presentation of the colors by the Danville High School Color Guard, we ask you to stand and join soloist William Olson of the University of Illinois in the singing of our national anthem as it's played by the Danville High School Pep Band.
The Danville High School Pep Band. They'll be performing here all afternoon and all evening as They play our national anthem and the presentation of colors here at Champaign at the Assembly Hall. So right now the pressure is on as far as both ball clubs are concerned. Let's take a look at the ball clubs, the coaches, and the starting combinations. Back to Tom Trent.
And now, ladies and gentlemen, let's meet the coaches and players involved in our first quarterfinal round game of the day. First, for the Wildcats of Evanston Township High School, their record, 30 wins and no losses. The head coach of the Wildcats in his ninth year with a career mark of 182 wins, only 86 losses, Herb Williams. Number 10, Jim Finucane. Number 11, Mike Cobb. Number 32, Eric Dortch. Number 40, Brian Brown. Number 42, Kevin Ackles. Number 43, Steve Wool. Number 50, Francois Jean Paul. And now let's meet the starting lineup for the Evanston Wildcats.
Evanston 30-0 coming into this one.
At forward, a senior, 6'2", number 44, Lewis Wool.
Lewis Wool, a straight-A student, fine ball player.
At forward, a senior, 6'4", number 35, Tony Mason.
Another solid front liner on this very well-balanced Evanston ball club.
At center for the Wildcats, a senior, 6'9", number 45, Steve Kling.
Kling, the tallest athlete to ever play basketball at Evanston, 6'9".
At guard for Evanston, a senior, 6 feet tall, number 33, Derek Brown.
Averaging 7.9 points per game.
And at guard for Evanston, a senior, 6'2", number 21, Everett Stevens.
Everybody's all-stater, Everett Stevens, a 6'2", 160-pound senior, a 17-year-old. Evanston won the title in 1968 with a 30-1 record. This is their second double-A appearance, their seventh all-time appearance.
Now let's meet the Rangers of Benton High School with a record of 24-6. The head coach of the Rangers in his 24th year with a career mark of 497 wins, 185 losses, Rich Herron. Number 23, Jeff Johnston. Number 32, Troy Hewlett. Number 33, Chris Head. Number 42, David Peters. Number 45, Tony Schell. Number 50, Jay Bradshaw. Number 54, Jeff Thompson. And now let's meet the starting lineup for the Benton Rangers. At forward, a senior, 6'7", number 55, Bruce Baker.
Another unanimous all-stater, 23-point-per-game scoring average.
At forward, a junior, 6'4", number 30, Randy House.
Averaging 11.2, shooting 52% from the field.
At center for the Rangers, a sophomore, 6'7", number 35, Jay Schaefer.
6.1 average, 58% field goal shooter.
At a guard for Benton, a senior, 6 feet tall, number 20, Kai Nurnberger.
Nurnberger, a Rotary Exchange student, he's averaging 8.5.
And at guard, a senior, 6'3", number 31, Darren Carlisle.
Carlisle with an 8.6 scoring average, and there's your combination. Let's take a look at the officials. Harry Bone from Clarendon Hills and Matt Lorich from Aurora. And one of your network sponsors is Country Companies Insurance.
Last week, Susan's new Buick was totaled. Market value was much less than the cost of a brand new one. So, Susan, how are you getting around these days?
In my brand new $11,000 Century, Country Companies replaced my totaled car totally.
Terry paid $12,000 for his new convertible. When it got wrecked, he found cost of repair would be higher than the cost of a brand new one. So he must have had to part with a big chunk of cash. Right, Terry?
Nope. Just the $100 deductible. My keeper policy got me a brand new one. Just like it.
The keeper policy provides full repair or a new car for the first four model years. Coverage like this helps explain why so many people stick with Country Companies. Right, Walt?
I'm just glad I've got the keeper from Country Companies.
Ask your Country Company's agent about the keeper.
You've got the country behind you. You've got the Country Company.
All right, there's the map of the land of Lincoln. Evanston, of course, in the Chicago area, a member of the Central Suburban League South Division. Benton out of the tough South 7 Conference. Located downstate in Franklin County, Benton's enrollment 725, Evanston 3,550. Okay, we're set to go. There you see the lineup was given to you by Tom and Fred a moment ago. Benton in his home white, trimmed in maroon. Evanston in his traveling navy blue, trimmed in orange and white. Ron Nikovich, is he all set?
All ready to go, and it promises to be a great ball game, and I think this game will begin what pretty shapes up to be a great tournament.
All right, Schaefer steps in to jump for the Benton Rangers. And he'll be skying there against Everett Stevens, a guard, but of course he jumps center. That tells you something right off the bat.
He's an all-around player.
Oh, he is. Derek Brown controls for the Wildcats. On the right side is Tony Mason. Now, Evanston comes out front to Derek Brown. Into the right corner, number 35 is Tony Mason. Here's Everett Stevens, the All-Stater. Benton sagging back in his own defense. A lot of size on the floor. Stevens down the lane, shot on the back iron. No good. Cling on the tip on the whistle.
Looks like he went over the top. That's what his own defense will provide you with, is good rebound positioning. And a player, of course, by the time that ball's in play, he's got to make his move to get inside position to rebound. Otherwise, you're going to go over the top and you have the inevitable call.
Yeah, Cling is 6'9", 210-pound senior, straight-A student. All right, the Benton Rangers against some pressure here, Ron, right off the bat.
Right early. We're going after him right now.
Number 20 is Kai Nurnberger, the exchange student from Germany, up over the time stripe to Randy House, wearing number 30. Back to Nurnberger out front. He's playing the point guard position. Let's see where Baker's going. Baker is number 55, right side of your lane. He, of course, has a 23-point average, the team scoring leader, and the all-time scoring leader at Benton. There's a long shot by Nurnberger. No good. Rebound taken by House. He follows. He got
good, strong rebound. Really reacted well to that ball.
You know, it's amazing. Bruce Baker is the all-time scoring leader at Benton, and here's a school that produced Doug Collins and, of course, Rich Yunkus. Collins, the All-American at Illinois State, later with the 76ers. Evanston on the attack. Everett Stevens.
Well, that's why he's everybody's All-Stater. He went right into that zone defense and popped that easy 18-footer.
Nice soft rhythm jump shot. Darren Carlisle meets the double-teaming pressure from Evanston defensive zone.
Lots of pressure out there.
There's
that 10-second call.
Yep. Well, Evanston definitely presses with the idea of forcing the turnover, getting the basketball. It's more than just harassment, isn't it, Ron?
It certainly is. They're going after that ball with the idea of turning it over. Just in that token pressure in the backcourt.
Derek Brown and Stevens are your guards for Evanston. Kling is number 45. He's got the ball in the middle. Turnaround by Kling. Up, off, no good. Rebound by Randy House. House 6'4", 180, a junior. Good solid board, man. Rangers come down quickly. Short jump shot, misfires. Baker tried for the board, couldn't get it. Deflected to Everett Stevens for the Wildcat. Stevens out quickly to Lewis Wool. Wool number 44 at the baseline. Oh, great block on the inside. Great block by Jay Schaefer. Benton running. Nurnberger back down. Left-hand layup.
Well, the West German player really showed us something on that play. He just went coast-to-coast to challenge Evanston all the way.
4-2 ball game. Benton leading by a bucket. Just underway. We've played 2 minutes in this quarterfinal battle. The first of four good ones on top today. Stevens, left side to Derek Brown. Everett Stevens in the corner to Lewis Wool. Right back out to Brown. Launches the jumper. And you see the result. Derek Brown, 6 foot, 155 pounds, a senior, 7.9 average, 4-4. We're going to see pressure all day long from Evanston. Lead pass to Baker. Solos. Blocked and fouled by Kling.
Early quick tempo in this ball game. All right, both teams are going up and down that floor at a furious pace. We'll see the long pass coming down court early on the breakdown court by the Rangers. And, of course, we see Baker going up strong and a foul on Kling going over the top.
Herb Williams forced to make a move early because that's foul number two on Kling. And in the Evanston lineup, checking in is going to be Francois Jean Paul, 6'5 and a half, a 210-pound junior. Jean Paul has been a very valuable reserve for this ball club. At the free throw line, Bruce Baker, 78% free throw shooter. Didn't get it. One more. Bruce Baker at the gratis line for the Rangers. Just a fair rebound. Pulling it down is Tony Mason. Mason's guy. Off to Brown. Brown to Lewis Wool. Here's Wool in the paint. Foul is going to be called, and this one will go against Bruce Baker and Ron Nikovich. That's our first PJ of the afternoon.
Yeah, I was looking forward to the first one. Actually, it was the Blue Jay, to tell you the truth.
Well, that's true. That's true. It was in the paint, right?
You got to get into the blue before you can get a Blue Jay. But I'll tell you, it's one of the art forms of the game today. Too many kids are going to try to penetrate all the way without pulling up and shooting that pull-up jump shot, which is an art form of the game today. We saw an early one, of course, by the great player, Everett Stevens.
At the line, Lewis Wool, Art Kimball, Frank Fasoni, and, of course, our commentator, Ron Nikovich, the veteran head coach at Lyons Township High School in the Grain.
Little heavy on that one, but excellent form by that free thrower.
Boy, both clubs are having their troubles at the line. Frank?
Art, Rich Herron mentioned to me before the game he'd like to slow Evanston's tempo down. I'm not sure he likes this tempo right now, even though Benton's a high-scoring team at 70 a game.
Tough to slow it down against this kind of pressure, and I know that's probably what concerns Rich at the moment. Wool missed a pair. Nobody's made a free throw as yet. We've had a total of four attempts, and each club has missed two. Rangers with the basketball. Ty Nurnberger, number 20. He's 6'7". He's the West German exchange student. House to Nurnberger in the corner. You ever get a transfer like that at LaGrange, Ron?
Oh, God, we don't get that lucky. Got to work at that Rotary Club in Western Springs and LaGrange gets them on the ball.
I would hope so. Bounce pass deflected out. They're going to say off the fingertips of Jay Schaefer, apparently, although it looked like Francois Jean Paul may have had a hand on the basketball. At any rate, goes right back to the Wildcats, tied at four.
Titans changed their defense now. It's more of a 1-2-2 look. Earlier, it was a 2-3 zone.
Everett Stevens, number 21, off to Brown for the jumper. Good. Make it Tony Mason. Mason with the 10-footer, right side, 6'4".
Wildcats for Evanston.
Yeah, they really haven't penetrated for a bucket inside that zone as yet, have they? Stepping on the drive is Darren Carlisle. He's number 31. Here's Baker, and shot is up and off. Baker tumbles to the floor. The rebound is no good on the inside. A foul by Schaefer, no good. Another one by Schaefer, no good. And we've got a foul call finally on Gene Hall on the inside.
Well, that's the best offense you can have, you know, when you get two or three shots at a time. You see an unaccustomed shot from that distance, I suppose, for a kid like Baker. And, of course, the rebound comes off. And there's the second effort coming up with the third effort now.
Common foul on the out-of-bounds play. Back to live action. Schaefer shot caromed off. And as you can hear, the official very audibly in our backboard microphone indicates that Benton had deflected the ball out of bounds. The Wildcats have the ball. We're at the 4:26 mark in the first quarter. 6-4, Evanston on the lead. There's your turnover count. Benton with three. Evanston with none. Stevens, just on the outer iron. Rebound, Mason. Rebound, Stevens. Deflected. Rebound, Gene Paul.
Furious rebounding at both ends of the court. Just furious. And I think what we're seeing is an unaccustomed physical game. I didn't expect this early on.
8-4, down the lane is House, gets the board, follows it to the side of the backboard. Rebound hauled out of there by Tony Mason. Here's Mason up the floor quickly to Derek Brown, to Stevens, 4-2.
Superb move, and the tempo favors Evanston at this stage, the quick tempo.
Evanston 30-0 on the campaign. Everett Stevens, you just saw their great All-State guard, gave you an indication why. Randy House, with a Schaefer throttling violation. Lineup change up coming now. It's going to be David Peters checking in, number 42 for Benton. He comes on for Randy House.
Art coach Gene Catalpa of Collinsville will be our guest at halftime. And by the way, we'll have a feature report on the great tradition of Collinsville on our telecast tomorrow afternoon. I hope you get to see it.
10-4 ball game here. Evanston by six over Benton. Tony Mason, number 35, working around the Benton zone defense. They go low. Dean Paul inside. Shot deflected by Schaefer. Stolen by Bruce Baker. Baker, big number 55, 6'7", 206-pounder. He motors down over the timeline. Right back out front. Fires the pass off to Carlisle. Left corner to Peters. To Baker. Power move. He got it.
Well, that's why he was last year's Southern Illinois Player of the Year.
Kind of think it's a little physical on the inside. The grunting and groaning going on as they drive the baseline.
A very physical game.
Everett Stevens. The feed low. Gene Paul put it on the deck. Lost it. Picked up by Lewis Wool on the foul. Lewis Wool, number 44, as you saw, grabbed the ball off the floor. Jay Schaefer is called for the first one.
The ball going, of course, inside, and the collapsing zone defense of Benton converges, and on the shot, well, there it is, the hand right across the wrist. There's an obvious foul, and a good call by our official.
Lewis Wool will be at the line shooting, too. He's missed it in two previous tries. On the season, he's an 83% free throw shooter. A little tension in the assembly hall, understandable.
You know, early on, Evanston does not show any pressure on him whatsoever. They are not playing like a team that has anything on their shoulders any more than Benton does.
Get off, guys. Well, every big test they've had this year, they've passed, Ron.
They've survived every one, haven't they? One more down here, everybody's undefeated as far as I'm concerned.
That's right. Willis Wool on the line, second period. He cages a pair, timeout, 2:51 to go in the first period. Evanston 12-6 over Benton, and one of your network sponsors, DeKalb Pfizer Genetics.
Around here, we can count on rain when we don't need it, no rain when we do, and if it isn't the weather, it's worrying about green bugs or disease, or if the crops will still be standing at harvest.
Because farm is so unpredictable, most folks plant DeKalb Pfizer grain sorghum. They know it's the best around.
When you can't count on the weather, you better be planting something that you can count on. I am.
In 1978, the Apple II was the most popular personal computer because it was the only personal computer available. In 1980, it was the most popular because it ran the most software. In 1983, it got more powerful and reliable. In 1984, we simply made it easier to use, which just may make the world's most popular personal computer even more popular.
Pro Computer Center. We'll make you a computer pro. In Carbondale, Mount Vernon, Centralia, Cape Girardeau, and Poplar Bluff.
Whale of a ball game. Only way to put it right now. Benton down 6-12-6, trying to solve the Evanston press. You look at the Evanston enrollment. Evanston High School is bigger than a lot of cities in Illinois. 3,550. Big high school. Traditional athletic power, of course, in the suburban area. Defensive zone, Nurnberger to Baker. Baker breaks the heat over the timeline. Big number 55, all Hamley there for the Rangers. To Nurnberger, Kai Nurnberger, the German exchange student in the left corner. Back out front now to Carlisle. Carlisle drifting, trying to back in on Evanston. Right side of the floor, now Benton out front. Nurnberger's jumper, back iron, no good. Great tip, but it didn't go. Trying to tip the ball. Looked like number 42 got a hand on it. Couldn't get it down. That, of course, would be Peters. And Evanston brings it back against the Benton zone. Ron, what have you picked up out of the Benton defense?
Out of the Benton defense, we've seen a 2-3 zone so far. And, of course, one time we had a 1-2-2 look. But it looks like it's vulnerable outside to that kind of thing. There isn't anybody really challenging that kind of shot, which happens to be, I believe, the 8 points from the outside for Evanston.
Yeah, Tony Mason drilled it in, number 35. And we have an offensive foul at the timeline called on the Rangers.
Wow.
Goes against David Peters. What about the Evanston defense once they fall out of the pressure?
Once they fall out of the pressure, they've been going into the man-to-man, although I think the last time down the court I was trying to detect, I think it was his own defense.
I thought it was, too. I thought it was a 2-3, but it was really sagged back in to cut Baker off.
I think that's what Benton needs to do to get the ball to Baker down on the low block.
Well, right now, it's Evanston more firmly in command, perhaps, even the 8-point lead might indicate. They're up 14-6, but Benton has hit a long dry spell. On the baseline, Wool launches the shot. He had to change the trajectory a great deal as he tried to tie it in left to right. Baker down quickly for the Rangers. Good baseline. Oh, what a block.
Great block.
Explosive block by Everett Stevens. Outlet pass. Nurnberger with the intercept. To Baker. Baker down low. Driving. Good by Peter.
Transition basketball at its finest.
14-8. Rangers back within six. Wildcats on the prowl. Circling in and back out was Lewis Wool.
The pace of this game. Right now, the bench factor is going to plug in because I can see kids out there now to begin to tire a little bit. Early in the first quarter.
Hung in the air, fakes the jumper, off to Brown. Back iron on the jump shot by Derrick Brown. The rebound hauled down by Benton's Jay Schaefer. Schaefer goes 6-7, pulled down that defensive rebound. Benton can close within four right now. A minute and three to go in the quarter. By Nurnberger. Off to House. Back to Nurnberger. To Baker. Baker drives. He got it.
Great move. Power move by a powerful 6-7 player.
The Rangers have closed within four. They're trying to escape a jinx which has occurred in the quarterfinal round here at Fort Benton in both A and double A play. They have not gotten past the quarterfinal round in the state tournament in their illustrious history. And of course, they would like nothing better than to do that out here this afternoon. We're down to 32 seconds in the quarter. It looks like the Wildcats are going to sit on it, play for the good shot. They're up four. Their biggest lead has been eight. It's a 14-10 contest. Just holding the ball out front is Derrick Brown. Brown now to Everett Stevens. Smooth as silk backliner. 6'2", a 160-pounder, ticketed for the Purdue Boilermakers.
And the way
back left to go.
It looks like it's going to turn out to be an outside shot.
Brown in the paint, pulls it up, shoots and got it, but it's not going to count traveling.
Great penetration move.
So Rich Herron's Benton Rangers will get the last crack at it here in the first quarter. If they score, they can pull within two. Full court pressure, of course, being applied by Evanston. Inbounded, Peters to House, down to 4 seconds, down to 3 seconds, down to 2 seconds. House in the paint, jumper, no good. Just barely carried up. They got a pretty good shot at that. That's it after one quarter. Evanston on top, 14-10 after one period, and one of your network sponsors is John Deere.
Now, things are different when I was a kid. Take my lawn mowing business. In the old days, I'd go door to door with a push mower. Today, I use a John Deere lawn and garden tractor. Supplied by my financial backer. This beauty will knock off an acre in 40 minutes. And the way she's built, she'll last for years. In fact, I'll probably run out of lawns before I run out of tractor.
Hey, big shot. You want to finish ours before you retire?
Ranger country is winning country. And these Benton boosters would like to say thank you to Coach Rich Herron and to all the Benton Rangers for a number one season. Sue's Pee Wee Shop, Mine Weld Incorporated, H2O, Western Auto, and Wisely's Menswear. Congratulations, Benton Rangers. You're number one with us.
Extremely well-played ball game, this opening game in the quarterfinal round of the AA State Tournament. Rangers back out on the floor in their home white uniforms, and here are your first period shooting figures. Evanston, a good solid 6 of 14, as you see in the opening quarter, shooting 42%, but Benton is a chilly 5 of 17, just 29%. Free throw is not a big factor, but Evanston has 2 points via the gift line. Rebounding 12-8 Benton. That's interesting. Turnovers. Benton with 4, Evanston with 2, and we're set to go with Chapter 2, Ron Nikovich.
Yeah, we're not going to see 5 for 17 shooting again this quarter. I think Benton's going to be getting that ball inside more than they were, and I think their shooting percentage is going to improve considerably during the course of the second quarter.
Keep in mind, Steve Kling, the 6'9" Evanston center, picked up 2 first period fouls and probably didn't play half the quarter. Inside, they go to House. He whirls and in and out. No good. Great rebound. Pulled down by Carlisle. He was happy. Carlisle got in the paint, and he really found the going sticky on the inside.
The kind of thing I'm talking about. I really didn't expect that Benton would be quite this physical, but they are not only physical, but they're a little bit on the finesse side as well.
They are, and you know, Benton shoots 52% from the field for the season, so Ron's right. You're not going to continue to see 29.
Benton averaging 70.3 points per game offensively. 55.2 is a very good defensive average. Free throw line, Carlisle. Well, so far, the free throw shooting touch has escaped the Rangers. They're a 68% shooting team. They're 0-3 at the line. One more throw to Darren Carlisle, 6'3", 181, a senior. This is a veteran Ranger ball club. Second throw is up and in.
They needed that one. I think the confidence factor will increase now. They'll be better at the line.
14-11, 3-point lead to the Wildcats, and they have the basketball. Derrick Brown. Number 33, off to Lewis Wool. Let's see where Everett Stevens is. There he is. He's got the basketball. Left side to Brown. Tony Mason breaks out toward the pass. He's number 35. Look at Benton, still back in that zone defense. Brown over the zone. on the iron, won't go. Rebound struggle for. Everett Stevens out of traffic. He's going to take it right back out and set it up again against his own defense. Almost a 1-2-2, Ron.
It's a 1-2-2, but the top two players wing out, and it has something of a three-out and two-in look.
Baseline jumper, Mason. Won't go. Oh, great rebound. Pulled down by Randy House. He is a bull. 6'4", a 180-pounder. Betting on the move. Jump shot by Carlisle, and Carlisle got pushed after the shot, it looked like.
That would be a two-shotter.
Gene Paul, I think, picked up the charge. Yep, or not the charge. Francois Jean Paul called for pushing off his second personal. He's 6'5 and a half, a 210 pounder. Great Evanston teams always have that bulk, don't they?
Yeah, you remember that 1968 team that Jack Burmaster had down
Rocky
here.
And Perrin and those kids.
Oh, boy.
They were men among boys that year.
Harold Jones.
Yeah, wasn't too bad a basketball team. They won it. Free throw is good. The oddity is, Ron, of course, if Evanston can keep going, that team in 68 won with a 30-1 record. This team right now is 30-0. They would surpass that win total with a victory here.
Art, that's the first undefeated regular season team in 100 years of Evanston athletics. And congratulations to Herb Williams.
Great team. Herb's done an excellent job. Second throw by Carlisle Karamzov. It's 14-12. Evanston was down at this point once, 14-6 in the first quarter. So they have closed the gap. To say the least, Lewis Wolf to Brown, Everett Stevens. Well, need we even describe that? As you can see, Mr. Stevens, with that fiery touch, drills it in.
A multi-talented player.
16-12, now Evanston back to a four-point lead. On the left side of the floor, it's Carlisle out to Ty Nurnberger. Nurnberger into about 17, can't shoot it. Baseline jumper, Carlisle. You keep getting the feeling that Darren Carlisle wants to get into the offense, and he's become much more active in the second quarter. Evanston by a pair, 16-14. Across for the Wildcats, Derek Brown. Brown to Mason, to Lewis Wool. Wool holding, looking off to Brown. Lob in the middle. Twisting to the right, and a foul is going to be called. Back out there. Well, I shouldn't say back out, really out for the first time, a 6'5" Kevin Ackles. So has this come in?
On the replay, we'll see a great spin move in the pivot. A little fake to the right, to his right, spinning around to his left, and he went up with a very nice off-the-glass turnaround J. A little bit late, though, the foul before the shot.
First foul on Randy House. Evanston inbounds. That's Ackles out there wearing number 42 for Evanston. Brown, free throw line extended left to Ackles. He launches. Got it.
That was a great assist there. A little ball fake, got the defense up in the air and dropped the drop pass in there. And
well, Ackles tossed that one in at short range, 18-14. Evanston's lead back out to 4 points as across comes Benton. Baker dies on the floor for the loose basketball. Going to call him for traveling. Call for walking with the basketball, and as a result, he goes back to Evanston with a very hard-earned four-point lead. Nothing's been easy in this game, has it, Ron?
Sure hasn't, but that was great hustle on Baker's part going on the deck for the ball.
Wildcats across. It's Wool. They look inside to Ackles. They get it to him. He turns. He shoots. It's on the iron. No good. Great rebound. Baker, and he's hammered.
Rebounding is just ferocious.
Everett Stevens picks up the first. No, his first.
Well, that kid Baker, he wears a blue collar, he wears a white collar, and it won't be long before his uniform turns red. He's just a worker.
But he will not go for the collar in the scoring or rebounding column, will he?
Sure won't.
Baker is at the line where he's 0-2 as a free throw shooter. Pretty good on the year, 78%.
Impressive.
Shooting a pair. Or 1-1, actually. And this is rebound deflected. Benton controls it. House on the baseline after the deflection from Jay Schaefer. Back out front to Nurnberger. Look at Baker trying to post up on the inside. In the right corner is Carlisle. Carlisle flashes back out now. He's number 31. Here is House. Baker, number 55, with a power move. Can't get it home. Deflected right side with the basketball. Again, controlling is Carlisle. So Benton keeping it alive. Trying to post up inside his own defense. House on the perimeter. And have a holdout foul. And this one is on Ackle. The official made the comment underneath, too much. A little bit too much body contact in there. And at the free throw line, in a 1-1, once again, will be Bruce Baker.
So Baker earned that free throw because he really works the post up hard to pivot. And in doing so,
he's continually working to get the kind of good offensive position that enables him to get the pass without making an unnecessary bumping foul, reaching over, and that kind of thing.
1-1 for Baker. Finally, another one at the line. He missed his first three attempts. He breaks the drought as he threads the needle there. It's 18-15. Evanston has led throughout.
Doesn't waste any time at the free throw line. Two bounces and he fires.
And he got a pair. 18-16. Evanston lead down to two once again.
And now there's Baker at the top of the zone press.
Quickly on the drive. Wool bangs it a bit too hard, but Lewis Wool gets his own board. Deflected back out here to Brown. Brown in the paint. PJ is up and in, and a blue jay, as Ryan would call it. Foul is on House.
Very physical game. Very physical game. If there's anything to be learned by the game at this point now, as far as our young players in the audience are concerned, it's how to rebound. Because both teams are going to that for that ball and at the glass in a ferocious pace.
Randy House leaves as his second personal foul for Benton. On his head is David Peters, 6'1", 174. Peters is just a sophomore who has played a very vital role. Of course, he was in the game earlier this afternoon. Derek Brown trying to complete the three-pointer. 20-16, Evanston. No good. Rebound hauled down by Jay Schaefer. Schaefer, good extension on that rebound. Held the ball out over the end line. Nobody was going to get a hold of it, and the Rangers bring it up. Now Evanston is going to straight up man-to-man again, Ron.
Yeah, they're back to the man-to-man. They have been in it most of the half. I think that we saw zone just on a couple of occasions. But they're working hard to try to get the ball inside to Baker. He's really posting up, and there it goes.
There's a lob to Baker. Got it. Ockel tried to cut him off, and Baker up with that little soft jumper at about 3 feet. 20-18. Evanston's lead is one. Everett Stevens in the right corner. Eyes the bucket. Can't shoot it from there. Back out to Derek Brown. Oh, what a battle this is, then. Evanston 20, Benton 18. Great ball game, no doubt about it. Lewis Wool to Derek Brown. They look to Ackles inside. Here's Stevens. Stevens works off to Mason. Mason shot on the iron with Darren Goff. The rebound controlled by Darren Carlisle. Everybody rebounds for both of these ball clubs.
It's going to be interesting to look at the rebound figures in our next graph on the stats on rebounding.
Yeah, at the quarter, the lead belonged to Benton. We'll see if Evanston has closed that gap. This is Ty Nurnberger, number 20.
Rolling a man-to-man. Baker's outside.
Yeah, being covered by Brown. They've got Mason on Baker. That's a big assignment for Tony Mason. Peters to Nurnberger for two.
He's a fine shooter. Great technique. Tough shot.
Shooting at 54% from the field and 82% at the line on the season.
And he's got the gleam in his eye.
First time it's been tied, 20-20. The Rangers have rallied. They were down eight once in the first period. Lewis Wool can't get it. The rebound, Jay Schaefer for Benton.
His zone defense. Zone defense has given him the inside rebound positioning, which has been a factor early on in his ballgame.
Ty Nurnberger, number 20 across, to Peters, the sophomore in the left corner, number 42. They swing it to Carlisle, top of the circle. Won't go. Rebound, Ackles. Ackles on the outlet. Gets it off to Everett Stevens. To Brown, back down the lane to Wolf.
Pretty play. A clinic, a classic three-on-one break. It materialized initially two-on-one and finalized three-on-one. It was a classic break.
Timeout for Benton with 2:40 to go in the half. Evanston leads it by two at 22-20, as you see. And one of your network sponsors is Country Companies Insurance.
The Johnsons always loved their home the way it was.
A breeze come out.
But then they had a fire in the kitchen that spread to the family room. No one was hurt, but the fire did destroy a pretty important electric train setup. Tell us, Beth, how did you explain that to the kids?
All I can say is Country Company's got us back on track in a hurry.
You got the country behind you.
For fair, understanding claim service.
You got the country company.
Special times at home and exciting events are times to remember, and Curtis Mathis has a great solution to capturing these moments forever. With the Curtis Mathis video camera, you can record everything from birthdays to sporting events. This camera has servo zoom and built-in microphone, and with the Curtis Mathis video camera, there's no waiting for film processing. All you have to do is rewind the tape and enjoy. If you really compare, Curtis Mathis has to be your choice. Curtis Mathis has a 4-year warranty on all parts and labor. Curtis Mathis, with locations in Mount Vernon, Centralia, Carbondale, Marion, and DuCoin.
You know, when teams are very successful, there's your rebounding situation. Benton still by six, Ron.
You know what? And I wouldn't be a bit surprised 8 minutes down the road that thing changes.
That's the way the rebounding is going here. The flurry has favored Benton in the early stages of the contest, but statistically speaking, but it's going to be a factor that's going to impact the game, obviously, down the hall.
Well, Ellison's going to take a timeout right here as Herb Williams apparently not particularly satisfied with what he saw, and he wants a timeout. Let's remind you that John Deere, Country Companies Insurance, and DeKalb Pfizer Genetics, happy to again be presenting this tournament action. And we hope you're enjoying our coverage. Of course, be with you throughout this AA state tournament. I was going to mention, fellas, I know during our last break, Frank, you were talking about the McLeansboro Ball Club that won the Class A state title last weekend, twice defeated Benton, 61-55. That was early on in the season, and then 48-45 in the Benton Invitational. It gives us an indication as to how good that McLeansboro State Championship Club is, because Benton is not a bad ball club by any stretch of the imagination.
They're really not, and as you see, coming up, Westchester St. Joe and Harvey Thornton in our second quarterfinal game. That'll be the quick feet and the powerful people, and that's a very good matchup, too.
Certainly is. You see the St. Joe Air Force against the artillery and tank forces of Thornton and Harvey.
By the way, Art, the other losses for Benton, Madison, Carbondale twice, and Centralia.
All good ball clubs. All right, making the play in against the pressure.
There's a 5-second count.
5-second count. Yeah. Over to Evanston. As you see, two of Benton's losses, as we mentioned, were to Class A state champion McLeansboro. One of them in the Benton Invitational Tournament after the first of the year. All right, Evanston on the turnover, inbounds. Here's Everett Stevens. He fires it up there, won't quite go. Rebound is reflected after a little contact.
Very physical game.
Nurnberger and Stevens collided in the air. Ball came out free, and Evanston's got it.
Two bits of contact.
Stevenson got away with a foul there.
Wolf trying to slide the baseline right. He's number 44. Ackles is number 42 in the middle. There's Mason. He can't get it to drop.
Where's that rebound?
22-20 ball game. Evanston by a pair, and Benton looking for the equalizer. Jay Schaefer trying to post up inside. They go right side to Peters. Peters looking. Flips it out front now to Randy House for Rich Herron's ball club. 24-year coaching veteran at Benton High School. Boy, they've had some great players over the years. Here's Baker. He's one of the great current players.
And
he's
got a power move. And, you know, for Rich Benton, three wins gives him that magic 500. What a way to get 500 wins.
Oh, the state tournament? Well, the state championship.
That's exactly correct.
Everett Stevens. Wow. Got no good. Ty Nurnberger picked up the personal. You know, for as physical as this game is, fellas, we really haven't had much in the way of personal fouls. And now Rich Herron is going to take his second time out. Of course, that probably is allocated for a half. Timeout for Benton is 22-22. And one of your network sponsors is DeKalb Pfizer Genetics.
Farming is a tough way to make a living. Most farmers are in a struggle just to survive. I know I sure am. So when I come after you to plant DeKalb Pfizer Genetics seed, you better believe it'll be the same seed that's done the job on my own farm. It's my job to know what kind of seed you need, not because I'm a seed dealer. Because I'm a farmer, like you. Who's in the struggle with you? I am.
It's the Spring RV Recreational Lot Show at Larry's Trailer Sales, north of Ziegler on Highway 148, March 23rd, 24th, and 25th. Three big days of displays of motorhomes, travel trailers, custom vans, and camper tops by Holiday Rambler, Alumalite, Honey, Terry, Resort, Taurus, U.S. Coach, and Lear. Save 10% on all RV, van, and pickup accessories in the store March 23rd, 24th, and 25th during the Spring RV Recreational Lot Show. That's Larry's Trailer Sales and Service, 3 miles north of Ziegler on Highway 148.
And there you see the battle of the boards. Benton still up 6, 21-15. A game played viciously under the hoop here this afternoon.
You know, that's a lot of rebounds for a game that's not even halfway over.
That's 22-22 also. All right, at the line is Everett Stevens. 1-1 situation. Evanston All-Stater. Deep breath. So Stevens now with 7 points.
He's eyeing that hoop all the way.
Wildcats 23, Rangers 22. 1:39 for the half. Good look at Everett Stevens. Jay Schaefer.
What we need to look at is how many offensive rebounds Evanston had. It'd be very few out of their total of 15, I suspect.
Carlisle baseline, kind of threw it away, but it's retrieved by a teammate out front, Randy House. House, a little bit of a redhead. He works the ball inside to Baker. Baker, power move, and he drew the foul. Nice assist by House.
Baker really knows what he's doing when he goes to the basket. One thing he doesn't do is jump very well, but he certainly uses his body extraordinarily well. We'll see that ball going into that blue-collar worker, Bruce Baker, of course, giving a little pump fake, goes up strong with his body, little hang time in there, draws the foul, and the foul, the shot, of course, falls just slightly short.
Foul is on Ackles, that's his second, so there's been four fouls, and the guys play in the middle for Evanston. Free throw by Baker is good, and let him correct that. More than four, because Francois Jean Paul also picked up two. Six fouls, and the guys in the middle. Baker knocks in the second one, we're tied. Well, he missed the second one, pardon me, 24-23. Still, our Benton got it. We'll get it straight here in a minute. Benton took the lead.
Takes his first lead.
I was looking down at the scorecard. Here's the jumper on the baseline by Stevens. Rebound Stevens. Ackles with the shot. Won't go. Benton with his first lead of the ball game at 24-23.
That zone is really packed in there, and of course, it's cutting off any effort on Evanston's part to get offensive rebounds.
Evanston playing the man-to-man. Here's the pass for Baker. It deflected out of bounds. It must rule that Everett Stevens got a handle the ball to the baseline.
He did.
So back Benton here with a one-point lead on the ball. Carlisle, Nurnberger, almost down, wouldn't quite drop. Great rebound, Tony Mason. Mason off quickly to Derek Brown. Brown to Everett Stevens. Right back to Brown. There's the penetration in the paint. Won't go. Baker kind of one-hands the rebound, lost possession of it, and Evanston's going to have the basketball. There's your turnover count. Benton with six. Evanston with two. Benton has the edge on the boards, Ron, but they also committed four more turnovers.
Yeah, early on they have, but the turnovers haven't been that crucial. Not yet, anyway.
There's Herb Williams on the Evanston bench. He looks concerned, as are all coaches in the state tournament. 24 seconds to go in the half. Evanston ball handling. Will they look for one good one here in the half?
That outside shot is there. All the seam shots are there. It's a matter of patience. Who's going to take it? Looks
Everett
like Stevens.
Got it. The all-stater. Girls in his 9 points. 5 seconds for the half. Down to 2 seconds. Long jumper by Nurnberger. Oh, Nurnberger threw it in.
Right
just inside the timeline.
Right on the money.
Ty Nurnberger about one stride inside the 10-second line. Let's take a look at it again, Ron.
Nurnberger did what he had to do. He pushed the ball up the court as quickly as he could, and it's a pull-up jump shot. We call that a PJ for about 95 feet. Bingo.
Nothing but net at halftime. Benton on top at 26-25, and one of your network sponsors is John Deere.
Have you ever noticed that sometimes the best you can do is settle for second best? Now you won't have to with the new R-Series riding mower from John Deere. You see, they don't cost more than ordinary riders, but they're built with extraordinary features and first-class John Deere quality. So now, for the price of someone else's mower, you could have one of ours.
I'm Rob Stotler, one of the home sales specialists for Bob Stotler Building Centers in Herndon, Marion. Now is the time to come in and see our complete line of energy-efficient packages or custom-built homes that will save you money. We personally guarantee 100% on material and labor on your new home. So come in today for your free estimate and meet the lumber people of Southern Illinois who have been serving your building needs for over 56 years. We're the Bob Stotler Building Centers of Herndon, Marion, Illinois. We can build all or any part of your new home.
Well, the whale of a ball game. Certainly the score indicates that at 26-25. The lead by one to Benton. Benton trailed in this ball game once in the first quarter by a margin of 8 points. Came on and actually at the end of the quarter we're down just four at 14-10. Then outscored Evanston in the game's second period by a 16-11 margin to move into that one-point lead at halftime. Of course, it was Ty Nurnberger's long-range bomb at the end of the half. And here's individual scoring. First for Evanston, as you can see, leading the way is their all-stater Everett Stevens with a 9 point total. Lewis Wool has four, Tony Mason with four, Derek Brown with four, and Francois Jean Paul has a 2 point total. So that's quite a performance. And Kevin Ackles isn't up there, but he also has two. On the other hand, four of the Benton Rangers Leading the way is their all-stater, Bruce Baker, with an even dozen. They have 6 points out of Kai Nurnberger, four from Darren Carlisle, House with two, Peters with two, and Schaefer hasn't scored. So that's your scoring rundown, and now let's switch you to the end of the floor to Frank Bisogni and also Ron Nikovich.
Well, I tell you what, Coach Nikovich, you said to start this tournament, we're going to have a lot of fun, and it's going to be close, 26-25 on a rifle shot at the gun. And I think that everybody knew coming in here, Evanston had a wonderful basketball team. Benton's in the same category.
Benton is a really surprising team to me in the sense that they're not only blue-collar, but they're white-collar. By that, I mean they're a finesse team and a power team as well, and they're really doing a great job on the boards in addition to handling the ball as they bring the ball up the court.
Let's find out about Benton a little bit, if we can. Step in front of me, Gene. Step right over here. This is the head coach of Collinsville, of course, Gene Catalpa. And you played and lost to Benton. Is this a typical Benton performance?
Yeah, I think so, although they shot a little better against us. But they try to get the ball to Baker low, and they have been pretty successful the first half the times they've got him the ball. He's awful tough when he gets around the hole.
He really is. Let's let a couple of coaches talk about this game in a moment.
Coach, as far as the Benton defense is concerned, is this what they've been doing all year long, pretty much a zone team in the half court?
Yeah, they play zone, and they work hard, and I tell you what, they board awful well, I thought.
Oh, I thought they were a very physical board club and really did a great job of positioning on the boards as well, which is accountable for the decisive rebound advantage they have so far in the half.
Yeah, and Baker works awful hard inside. I've never seen a kid work that hard inside. He's really tough.
He really does a great job of working on the inside. And of course, early on, we saw him on the outside as well a few times.
I would ask Gene about the depth of Benton. It's such a physical game, and the board work is so physical, there's liable to be fouls. How do you evaluate Benton's depth?
Well, against us, they only play six kids, and that's all they've played, but they kind of rotate them, so he's giving each one of them a spell there to give them a breather. So they're not. I don't think they have anybody in foul trouble right now, so I think they're in pretty good shape going in the second half.
What do you think Evanston is going to do now? Do you think that they'll come out and extend that pressure again and try to go to the full court?
Well, I think Evanston shot awful well on the outside. The big kid got two fouls early. I'm kind of anxious to see if he's going to get back in there. Maybe he can help him on the boards a little bit.
And I think, too, at the end of the ball game, the shot that Kai Nurnberger hit has really given them the incentive that they need for the second half. The confidence factor has really risen quite a bit.
Yeah, that was a jump shot, too. That was not a set shot. Awful strong to shoot one from that far out on a jump shot.
Let's put you on the spot just for a second, because you're a basketball coach in one of the tradition-rich basketball cities in this state over all the years of high school basketball. Is there a favorite in this tournament? Who do you like?
I don't think so. I haven't seen a lot of the northern teams play, but I've been watching the scores, and nobody's really dominated other teams, and I just think it's wide open.
Well, thank you very much for coming over, and I guess you know we're having a feature on Collinsville and Collinsville basketball in our telecast tomorrow.
Yeah, they did that a month or so ago down at our place, so we'll be anxious to see that.
Congratulations on your season, and best of luck to you.
Thank you.
Gene Catalpa, the head basketball coach at Collinsville, and now let's go back to Art Kimball, and first we're going to take a break, though, and our network sponsor is DeKalb, Pfizer Genetics.
When it comes to being an optimist, nobody beats a farmer. I guess that comes from knowing that no matter how tough the winter, there's always the promise of new life come spring. And I guess that's how I feel about my new seed company, DeKalb Pfizer Genetics. A great product line now, and the promise of some really exciting things to come from some of the best seed research in the world. And you know who's backing that promise? I am.
Drudgery was a way of life for our ancestors. It made Grandpa cranky. But today, even lawn work is easier because Snapper has the key to quick starts. Electric ignition, the sign of today's most advanced machine. It even has an alternator, like your car, and a powerful high vacuum system. Snapper Electric Starter makes mowing a snap. And that's just for starters.
See this line? That's where I fill in my deduction for my King City Federal IRA. Hey, listen, if you didn't open an IRA in 1983, it's not too late. Go down to King City Federal, open an IRA before April the 15th, and you can still deduct it from your 1983 taxes. And while you're there, King City will show you how to make regular additions to that IRA all year long. So this time next year, that little line won't be blank. thanks to King City Federal.
One-point ball game at halftime. Benton on top, 26-25 over Evanston. Let's take a look at the shooting figures. You'll see them on your screen right now. The Rangers are shooting 37%. They didn't really bring theirs up a whole lot. They're 10 of 27, but Evanston's tailed off. The Wildcats at the half, as you see, are 11 of 31, and they're down to 35% shooting. Free throws, 6 of 11 already for Benton. 54%, just 3 of 7 for Evanston. Evanston shooting just 42% at the line. Neither club shooting their normal par at the free throw line. There's your rebound count, 24 to 16. Benton now with 8 more boards. Turnover 6-2. Benton with 4 more turnovers, but Benton has consistently hung on to that 6-8 rebounding edge. Is that significant right now?
It's significant to the extent that Evanston has not rebounded offensively very well at all. It isn't to their discredit, but rather to the credit of the Benton Rangers, who, of course, have packed in that zone defense. They're a physical ball club, and they go to the boards very well and go after that ball very well, and it's cut off that second effort on the part of Evanston. Evanston's shot percentage, as a consequence, has suffered. We remarked earlier, though, that Benton, we knew that Benton wouldn't go 5 for 17 right. Again. Well, they only got 5 field goals in that quarter. They did on a 10 attempt, so it's better than 5 for 17.
Well, the thing that's interesting to me is a decent job on Everett Stevens against the zone. Stevens has 9 points at halftime. He can light it up from anywhere. It looks to me like Evanston may be just a bit reluctant to take the perimeter shot. They're forcing inside a little bit. Do you think Herb Williams may say, let's take that 12, 14-footer?
I think he'll be inclined to say that, but I think they need to be just a bit more patient with respect to attacking that zone defense. Just a bit more patient. I think the outside shot will materialize more frequently for him.
In other words, one or two more passes, perhaps.
Why not?
One of your network sponsors is John Deere.
For years, people with big lawns have faced the same problem. What to do with the clippings? Now there's the John Deere 6.5 bushel twin banger. Two big hoppers you line with plastic trash bags, so cleanup's neat and easy. It could be the best way ever to take care of your clippings. We think everyone should have one. The twin bagger, available for John Deere lawn tractors and riding mowers.
It's Glottish Honda's annual open house. Come in and pick up your free Honda game puzzle. Play Honda's $150,000 instant winner Grand Prix game. The grand prize is a trip for two to Europe, the San Marino Grand Prix, and $20,000. There are European motorcycle tours, plus cash, Sony Walkman TVs, Kodak disc cameras, and more. Over 5,000 prizes in all. So come in to Glottish Honda off I-57 in West Frankfort. See the exciting new 84 Hondas, or make a great deal on a selected model. This could be the chance of a lifetime.
Well, of course, it's Benton and Evanston with a half to go, and then the second game this afternoon. What a barn burner that should be. The Chargers of Westchester St. Joseph against last year's third place finisher, the Wildcats from Thornton of Harvey. So a big day of basketball, and Frank Masoni, if this first game is typical of this tournament, it's going to be everything you and I thought it would be. Here's tonight's schedule.
Yeah, tonight we're looking forward to Champaign Centennial, the hometowners and Roger McClendon against Aurora West and Kenny Battle. Great teams lost only one game. Rock Island dumped a powerful Peoria Manual team. And, of course, Chicago Simeon. When you win the Chicago Public League Championship, you're a fine basketball team.
And Simeon doesn't have a fellow on the roster shorter than 6'4", that weighs less than 180 pounds. This floor is going to tilt. That's the size Dean Sinkovich used to have.
Used to have, right.
That was back in 70 when you won it all, right?
Right.
Okay, let's settle back for the second half. 26-25. Benton leads on an incredible bomb at the buzzer by Kai Nurnberger. He threw it in from Franklin County. There's the opening jump to start the third period. The Wildcats have it moving to your left in there, traveling the navy blue. Lewis Wool can't get it, but the rebound is up and in.
There's that offensive rebound that they need to have.
Steve Kling, who got out most of the first half with two fouls, got the tip in, his first point. Kling is not a heavy scorer, though he averages 4.1 points per game. And Evanston up 1-27-26. Now, what do we have from the Wildcats? Little zone here, it looks like.
No, they're playing man-to-man. It's man-to-man.
Baker on the jumper. 28-27 up.
You know, Baker reminds me a little bit of Gamble from Springfield Lampier last year and what he's doing offensively. He's all over the floor. He's inside, outside. He's medium.
Everett Stevens out of an air ball. That's very unusual. Here's a lineup change for the Rangers. Checking in is going to be David Peters, and coming out for Rich Heron is Jay Schaefer.
Jay Schaefer had a remarkable first half. You see him sit down. He had 11 rebounds. He's 16 years old, and he's 6'7".
All right, here's Evanston pressuring. I don't want to disagree with the coach, but I'm not sure Evanston's in a man-to-man. Let's see what they do.
Okay, we'll check it out.
Down low to House. Hooks it up, won't go. Rebound, fought for. Boy, the battle over the board is tremendous. Deflected out, and let's see who it's going to go to. The Rangers retain possession. Well, they'll zone on the inbounds play, for sure.
Yeah, they're in the zone this time.
They're changing up is what they're doing to us, Ron.
Well, I hope they don't confuse us too much.
I'm easily confused. I forgot about that. Nurnberger, well out, number 20. He's the exchange student from West Germany. This is the very, very talented sophomore, David Peters, number 42. Bruce Baker, well out on the floor. Evanston leads it by one, just underway in the third quarter. Baker to Peters. They're trying to get the ball to House inside with Kling all over him.
There's that outside shot again. Very reminiscent of the Lanphier attack last year. Featuring Kevin Gamble.
Yep. Baker so far now with 16 points. His average is 23 per game, so he's right about on target.
He's right there. He'll surpass that going into the fourth quarter.
All right, Benton now leading by three of 30 to 27. In the corner, Stevens. Got it. Everett Stevens narrows his margin to 1 point at 30 to 29.
Well, he's showing why he's everybody's all-stater.
Yeah, he and Baker certainly have not disappointed, have they?
As we said at the top of the show, this game will feature two players who are bona fide candidates for the Mr. Basketball Award, and they haven't disappointed anybody in that respect.
House's drive deflected. Baker's shot blocked, and Kling made both plays for Evanston. The big kid in the middle. Derrick Brown whirls in the paint, and a whistle, a foul on Nurnberger.
That was a great move there. Of course, Rich Herron is trying to get travel on that. I'm not too sure he's probably correct on that, but the foul occurred, I think, probably before that shuffle took place. And let's take a look at it. Yeah, the foul took place before the shuffle, so it was a good call.
Well, now leaving is going to be House. Randy House comes out, and Jay Schaefer comes back in.
Schaefer looks like he's going to be another in the long line of the great players that come out of the Deep South, out of Bettenland.
Schaefer with 9 boards. I think officially they had 11 for him in the first half of play. He has really dominated. Clayton, the 6'9" center, out to help out now.
Boy, that zone is active. Gosh, they work hard.
Derrick Brown follows
him
by Kling. Rebound, Wool. And Baker picked up the personal underneath. Heavy traffic, foul number 2 on Bruce Baker.
And we're looking at right now what appears to be and is going to be the key to the ball game, and that is how much offensive rebounding Evanston's going to do, and we'll see how much offensive rebounding they're capable of right here, particularly with Kling back in the ball game.
Derrick Brown inbound for the basket.
Over the top, can't count.
No basket. Crashing in, making contact, Everett Stevens, the basket disallowed. Spectacular play.
What an athlete.
Oh, what an athlete. He really skied. Benton will have possession of the basketball. Intently fought struggle. Benton 30, Evanston 29. Second foul on Everett Stevens. All right, the Rangers making the play. And Evanston's pressure was really intense early in the ball game. I felt, Ron, they eased it up a little bit in the second quarter.
Yeah, they did, but now they're putting it back on again now because they realize naturally that as you get into this stage of the game, you got to do it. You got to do what brought you. Look at that rebounding.
Peters with the rebound. Got the shot in. Basket's not going to count. Call for pushing off. Foul number 2 on David Peters.
Well, here comes, looking at the replay. We'll check this out. Now the shot. To miss the rebound one time, and of course the easy one. Now it's coming up, and don't quite have the angle to see it. Don't quite have the angle to make a comment on that one.
There's Rich Herron in the navy blue blazer, leaning over on the sideline, the Benton bench. The feed into Kling, the 6'9" at Jefferson Center. And he's been trapped in there a long time. The 3-second violation is called.
Traffic at that stage was too heavy to get the ball inside to the capable Mr. Kling.
On top of that, Kling couldn't get out. He got pinned in the lane. No way he could get out of there. That's the 3-second violation. Still 30-29 Benton.
That Benton zone is so active.
Turnover count 7-4. Benton with 3 more than Evanston. The Rangers have the basketball. Jay Schaefer. Ty Nurnberger. Benton trying to escape in the quarterfinal round of the state tournament. That has been their jinx over the years, despite the number of great Benton ball clubs that have come in here.
They've had some great ones come down here. I'm not too sure that this is the best one I've seen.
There's Peters, the sophomore, got it.
Well, there's that pull-up jump shot. It's a classic TJ, and that sophomore, I'll tell you what, he's got that thing down pat in a hurry.
Fine ball player, no doubt about it. What a valuable reserve he is. And Benton leads it by three. Quing for the Wildcats to Everett Stevens on the wing. Everett Stevens lights it up on the perimeter. 32-31. The Benton lead is just a point.
He's a highlight film.
Well, I'll tell you, this keeps up. I'm going to buy a ticket.
I'll wait to see that day. I don't know about you, Frank. Well, on the perimeter, Darren Carlisle in the corner. He feeds inside, and we have a reach out. Pass one into Jay Schaefer.
You know, I've commented about the activity of the defensive Benton, but they're equally active offensively. You see the inside play, the pass going inside, and of course Schaefer going after the ball. He goes after it.
Tony Mason picks up the foul, his second. Inbound to Peters. Benton playing very, very well, and they have just a one-point lead over Evanston. Baker, power move. Can't get it in. Tipped by Schaefer, not control. Back to Baker. Here's the basket for the count. Foul is on Lewis Wall. Basket is good.
That basket counts. That kid works. I'll tell you, as I said, he wears a what? Watch this kid work. The effort. Ball's a little short this time. Well, that's the one he hit. I guess the first one is the one that fell short. And of course, he's just so active offensively, as they are active defensively.
He's some thunder inside, isn't he?
Baker is at the line. He has a total of 18 points on the afternoon. 34-31 Benton lead. Make it 35.
Oh, Gene Bartow's watching this game. He's got to be happy because that kid's ticketed to go to UAB.
Alabama Birmingham on the perimeter. Stevens got short. Rebound controlled by Kai Nirenberger and Rich Heron, Benton Rangers with a four-point lead, their biggest edge. Carlisle to Peters, back to Baker. There's Bruce Baker, top of the circle to Nirenberger, back door to Schaefer.
How active they are offensively. The ball movement is just great. Great vision on their part, great patience. They're finding the opening.
Evanston takes the timeout, trailing by six at 37-31. One of your network sponsors, Country Companies Insurance.
When Terry's new convertible got wrecked, he found repairs would cost more than a brand new one. But fortunately, he had the keeper policy from Country Companies. So did you have to part with a big chunk of cash, Terry?
Nope. Just the $100 deductible. My keeper policy got me a brand new one. Just like it.
You've got Country behind you.
With the all-new Keeper policy.
You've got the Country Company.
If you're in the market for a new house, then a trip to Otteson Homes, Route 13 east of Carbondale, is a must. Otteson has a wide selection of factory-built houses. These houses can be set up on a foundation or basement, and Otteson has special 30-year financing on these homes. For just 5% down and a fixed rate of 13.5% over 30 years, one of these beautiful, spacious homes can be yours. Come by Otteson Homes and admire the beauty, comfort, and affordability of a new house at Otteson Mobile Homes, Route 13 east of Carbondale.
Here comes that great ball movement on Benton's part. The ball going inside, great vision, spotting the open man in the baseline, going up with that easy shot across the glass. And, of course, this has been the success so far that Benton has showed us offensively speaking. And the old Fox is there, 497 wins.
Rich Heron shooting for number 498 here this afternoon. 324 for the third quarter, 37-31 Benton. Evanston on the attack. Wildcats need a bucket. Derek Brown. Top of the circle, right side of the all-stater, Everett Stevens, baseline. Fires the air ball, and Baker with the rebound. Big, strong Bruce Baker pulls it down.
Baker again.
Rangers have the ball. Ty Nirenberger across, being hounded by Derek Brown out front. Brown almost deflected it away. To Peters. Now it's Carlisle. To Baker. The ball. Boy, Baker really horses on the inside. He bowled in there and got good position, but a fine defensive play by Steve Kling. And the lineup change now for the Wildcats. In the Evanston lineup, Mike Cobb, 6'1 and a half, 150, a 16-year-old junior. He's going to replace Everett Stevens. Give Everett a little bit of a breather.
He'll be back soon.
37-31. Benton's biggest lead right now, 6 points. The biggest Evanston lead was 8 in the first quarter. Playing at 6-9 against Baker at 6-7. Evanston has the basketball. Derek Brown. Brown lost the ball, got it back in the paint, shoots and scores, and he was fouled. The basket's going to go. Fouls on Schaefer.
We'll see the great penetration now. Almost lost the ball. Got a good bounce. Came back with it, and of course, on a perfect Blue Jay type shot over the outstretched defense of Benton.
Derek Brown has missed his only previous free throw try. It's now a 4-point ball game. He can narrow it to 3. Will go. Rebound controlled by the Rangers. Pulled out of there by Benton in the person of Darren Carlisle. Here's Peters. Well out on the floor. David Peters. In the middle to Baker. Ball is deflected away. Derek Brown with a great save, but Benton gets it back. Peters with the steal against Lewis Wall. He scores. David Peters got the loose basketball. Back to a 6-point Benton lead of 39-33. Inside. Driving for the hoop. Cobb shot won't go. Benton running. Nurnberger goes in. He misses it. The rebound. Carlisle tied up by Evanston center feet playing a hill jumper. Tough, physical, double-A tournament quarterfinal ball game.
And the pace hasn't slackened any from the very beginning until this point in the ball game. It's just been furious.
Leaving is going to be Jay Schaefer, and back out there for Benton is Randy House. And House and Baker, they really have a tandem at those forward positions. You talk about climbing the boards.
They really have.
Then what they don't get, Schaefer does. So very strong rebounding front line. Swing with a decided height advantage here. Tips it off easily, bringing the ball up quickly for Evanston is Mike Cobb. Cobb to the baseline. Feeds inside to Wool. Rolls the shot up. Will not go. And a foul on David Peters, his third.
Now we're seeing Evanston in a situation that they found themselves in many times down the tournament road. And early on against Maine East in their conference when they had some real classic confrontations with Maine East. So I think they're accustomed to this spot. I think they know what to do in terms of drawing back for the little extra that's going to take to pull it out.
Lewis Wool a great game. Wool with 4 points, as you see, for the afternoon. 2 out of 4 at the line. He'll make it 3 out of 5. He cashes in there. One more throw to Lewis Wool. Herb Williams in his 9th year, graduate of Evansville. 182-86 his record. Of course, Rich Heron is from McKendree College. 497 wins, 185 losses in 24 years.
That's a lot of basketball.
Well, he also coached at Oakville.
Right. Second throw is good by Wool. Everett Stevens comes in replacing Derek Brown. So they leave Cobb out there, get Brown out for a little breather. 2:05 to go for the third quarter. Benton 39, Evanston 35. Rangers inbound the basketball. David Peters in the defensive zone. The sophomore against the double team. Down the sideline, the pass to Randy House. House circles into the paint. Now he works it off to Darren Carlisle to Ty Nurnberger. Right side to Peters. Peters looks into House. House working on Wool and Stevens. Can't get the shot to drop. Rebound. Good defense. Controlled by Wool. Evanston on the move. Everett Stevens up and in.
Well, he came off the bench after that little breather. Still he knew what to do when he got in there.
39-37. The Benton lead, which was 6, has now been narrowed to 2. Ty Nurnberger across the stripe. Works out front to Dave Peters. Darren Carlisle, they look low to Baker, got the baseline, got the bucket. Baker explodes, 9-point quarter for Baker.
Great passing basketball team.
41-37, back to a 4-point Benton lead. The Rangers still in that zone defense. Has the look of a 1-2-2 again. Holding his Cobb, but Kling trying to post up inside for Evanston. Everett Stevens in the seam, right-hand jumper, got it.
I guess that rest helps, doesn't it?
Rest and a shooting touch like he's got crosshairs on his fingers.
17 points so far for Stevens. Dave Peters for Benton to House. House on the dribble drive, up and in with a left hand.
Penetration.
House put it on the deck, came back with the left hand and scored.
These teams aren't very good, are they?
No. Dull ball game, Frank, right? 43-39. Benton. Here's Mike Cobb. We're down to half a minute to go in the third quarter. Everett Stevens, the Cobb looks inside to Kling. Stevens lost to Cobb. Cobb at 14. Out to Tony Mason. Mason tries to move it. To Cobb. Baseline. Good move to Wool. Can't get it down. Baker blocked it. Wool rebounds it. In and out. And the foul is on Baker. That's a big ball. That's his third.
You know, we talked about how hard Baker worked. Well, this kid, Wool, I tell you, he's double Wool the way he's going in there. He just works and works some more, and he just could not quite get the correct roll.
Well, they pull House out, Randy House. I thought he might take Baker out with 17 seconds left and three fouls.
I'm not real sure, but, I'm certain Rich is aware of the fact that his star is riding with three. Or some kids can play in foul trouble, Ron, no doubt about it.
Yeah, we saw that last night, didn't we, in the National Telegraph game.
And they're also going to come down to the other end on offense in a second.
That does make a difference. Lewis Wool is at the line, shooting a pair. Wool is a straight-A student at Evanston High School. 6'2", a 170-pounder, a 17-year-old senior, 11.8 average, 83% free throw shooting.
Well, he shoots like it, too. The technique is just perfect.
Can pull his club within two.
Takes his time, concentration. He knows what he has to do. It's going to go.
Aaron off, the rebound, Schaefer had it, lost it, Evanston gets it back, and Stevens, they lose it out of bounds. Everett was battling, trying to find the handle. That basketball could become extremely elusive at times. House is checking back in. Schaefer came in as Rich Heron up prowl on the sideline. And you can see the back of the Evanston bench from that shot a moment ago. Herb Williams, rather calm. There's Rich Heron sitting down. He pulled Jay Schaefer up. Okay. 12 seconds to go, third quarter. Benton 43-40 over Evanston. Up quickly, Dave Peters. 8 seconds showing. Here's Baker out front. Jump shot is no good. Rebound deflected with 3 seconds. The save far side, and Evanston's got the basketball. Taking the shot, of course, was Darren Carlisle. He also made the save. But they couldn't convert, and that's it after three. After three periods of play here in the Assembly Hall, Benton 43, Evanston 40, and one of your network sponsors, DeKalb, the Pfizer Genetics.
Seems like farmers have to make do with less of everything. Less water, less fuel, and less money. It's really tough. So we're turning to crops that get the most out of our resources, like grain sorghum. When it comes to sorghum seed, most of my neighbors are turning to me and my DeKalb Pfizer hybrids. They know DeKalb Pfizer seed's the best around, or I wouldn't plant it myself. And who's the toughest customer I know?
Rangers, you're the best. Congratulations on a great season. And come on up to Benton Ranger territory. You're invited to share the Ranger winning spirit with these Benton boosters. B&J Home Improvement Center, Allen's Menswear, Terminex, Negreski Real Estate, and the Benton Community Bank. Congratulations, Rangers, for a great season. You're number one with us.
Minutes left in this one, maybe. Opening quarterfinal game here in the Assembly Hall. Upcoming, Westchester, St. Joseph, and Thornton to Harvey. They ought to pay rent on the Assembly Hall as often as they're down there. That's it after three. Benton, 18 of 42. The Rangers shooting 42%. Evanston, 17 of 46. They've gotten off four more shots, 37%. Free throwing, not a factor right now because they're about even. 7 of 12 for Benton, 6 of 12 for Evanston. Rebounding edge. Now Benton leads it by 9 on the board. 33-24. Turnovers 10-5. Benton with 5 more miscues. So statistically, we're pretty even, fellas, and we only got a 3-point ball game.
Yeah, they say basketball is a game of spurts, and I think a spurt will develop in the fourth quarter. I don't know which team's going to get the spurt, though. What Art said, the key word was maybe we'll have 8 more minutes.
Well, it was a double tip, and here is Rich Heron out discussing with one of the officials. Directly in front of the scorer's table, they're going to give the ball to Evanston. Well, apparently Rich is satisfied. I don't really understand the rule here, Ron, to be honest. It was a double tip is what it amounted to. Benton got the basketball. They gave it back to Evanston. I don't think Rich Heron totally agrees, but Rich is taking a seat. Herb Williams will take the basketball. Lewis Wolf, to Derek Brown. They look inside to Tony Mason, Everett Stevens. Here's Brown, number 33. Slices to the baseline against that zone. Zone is becoming tighter and tighter inside. Lewis Wool inside of Baker Travis. Now, of course, keep in mind, Bruce Baker, the superstar from Benton, has to be pretty careful out there, Ron. He's got three fouls, and he can commit a fourth, but they don't want it too early.
I'm sure he doesn't want it too early, but it seems to me that Bruce Baker plays at only one speed, and we've seen that speed throughout the first three quarters of the game.
Eric Bass, Eric Brown with the steal for the Wildcats. Oh, beautiful move by Stevens, right along the baseline. Did he explode or did he explode? Everett Stevens for the layup. Benton's lead is cut to one, 43-42. Ty Nurnberger, settle back wherever you're watching the action. We're going to have a fast and furious finish. Long jumper, Baker. No good. Rebound up and in. Great effort by Darren Carlisle coming off the weak side. 45-42, Benton by three. Derek Brown to Everett Stevens. Back to Brown. Free throw line extended left. There's a penetration by Brown, and there's the bucket.
Great shot.
Derek Brown got inside and drilled it. 45-44. Rangers by a single digit. Baker, left sideline.
I went over.
Nurnberger over and back.
The problem in a situation like that, too many players in the backcourt. He was caught one-on-four for a
long
time.
Look at Rich Herron is going bananas over on the bench. He is just real unhappy with the turnover.
Rich is a calm guy.
Yeah, very calm. Never gets excited. Mason, baseline jumper. Rebound. Wool and Baker battle, and Derek Brown, the little guy, comes out of traffic with it. Here's Brown with the pull-up. Good.
Give them that basket that they need at the right time.
Evanston grabs the lead. The Wildcats, 46, Benton, 45. Jay Shaver is going to come back in shortly for Benton, their starting center. David Peters, defensive zone to Darren Carlisle. Intercepted by Evanston. Wool with the steal to Brown. Brown pulls it up and in. Derek Brown with three straight buckets there at the start of the fourth quarter. And Benton's got to take a timeout. 6:09 to go. Evanston 48, Benton 45. And one of your network sponsors is John Deere.
Have you ever noticed that sometimes the best you can do is settle for second best? Now you won't have to with the new R-Series riding mower from John Deere. You see, they don't cost more than ordinary riders, but they're built with extraordinary features and first-class John Deere quality. So now, for the price of someone else's mower, you could have one of ours.
Hi, I'm Jim Hayes of Jim Hayes Incorporated in Harrisburg, Illinois. If you want it, we have it. The spring values on the full line of the best-built cars and trucks in America. We have over 100 new cars and trucks in inventory, and most are equipped with spring value packages, which give you the luxury options you want. If you're looking for a new Ford with savings up to $1,342, you'll find it at Jim Hayes Incorporated in Harrisburg, Illinois.
Coach Herb Williams played in the first state tournament game at the Assembly Hall back in 1963. 22 years the tournament has been played in this magnificent arena.
Place hasn't aged a bit.
No, nor have we. Up over the timeline, Nurnberger pulls it up in the paint and got it. Well,
what do you call that now? All right, now you tell me.
That's
what do you
a
call
PJ.
It? No, it's not.
Blue Jay.
There you go.
That worries me, though, if you play in an arena with a red lane. What do you call that?
Blue Jay.
48-47. But you got to pass the quiz when you work with Mikovic. Always the teacher. There's a jumper by Tony Mason. Got it down. 50-47. Evanston by three. Benton in the defensive zone. Darren Carlisle. Carlisle to Nurnberger. Ty Nurnberger. Look at Brown digging defensively on him. Derek Brown playing the good man-to-man defense now for the Wildcats. A lob to Baker. Baker was Kling on him. He can't get the shot in. Good defensive job by Kling, though. He forced that shot to misfire.
He got a little help, too.
Right. Round to Wool. Whistle. Offensive foul goes against Evanston.
Watch Randy House.
Pushed up the court. And there's the defensive good position there by House. And, of course, you know, like always, that Emmy Award helps. Little sound, little ball. Land hard, you'll get the call.
Boy, the old coach is even wax poetic. He's been rehearsing for this week. 50-47, Evanston. 5 minutes mark and counting. Final period. Pippen has led most of the second half. But right now, Everson in command. Everson with a steal. Evan Stevens. He's got the ball on his way. Basket counts, and he was fouled. Everett Stevens lights up the place with a spectacular drive. See how they're gonna call it. Foul's gonna go against Evanston.
Well, we have a little confusion on this now. He's going up in the air. The ball.
Okay, they awarded the basket. The foul is also on Everett Stevens. That's his third. The airborne shooter rule entered in Iran, but they ruled the contact was made by Stevens well after he released the basketball.
Yeah, it had to happen well after he released it for something like that to occur. And, of course, as we think back on the replay that we just saw, it's arguable whether that happened or not.
All right, Everett Stevens picked up the foul. The line is going to go Darren Carlisle.
He's got two key free throws coming up, potential two key points.
1-1 is the 5-point lead to Evanston. Free throw misses. Rebound saver.
Offensive rebounding again.
And Tony Mason is called for the reach in.
I say that they are key because Benton is doing all they can, of course, to deny Evanston the spurt that they have developed.
Now, you were talking about a spurt at the start of this quarter. Evanston's definitely had it. And right now they're riding the crest of that to a 5-point lead at 52-47 at the line. Is Jay Schaefer in a 1-1 situation. Both clubs are on the bonus. Important attempt there for Benton, to say the least. Well, Jay Schaefer, who shoots at a 78% clip from the line on the season, makes the first one. 52-48, a 4-point ball game.
4:49 to go. We've got an eternity to play.
And Schaefer gets a pair of mighty big ones. They weigh a ton, as they say. 52-49. Evanston by three. Derek Brown coming across. Everett Stevens off front with him. Brown number 33. Stevens number 21.
Zone remains essentially the same, although it's spreading out just a bit. And I think their concern is the outside shot.
Here's a steal. Howe steals it. Off to Nurnberger. Nurnberger solos in and got it.
Great move.
Ty Nurnberger with a solo drive. 52-51.
Body control was really super there.
Great move.
Mr. Nurnberger, the German exchange student, can play the game. There's no doubt about that. Lewis Wool for Evanston. There's Brown, number 33, top of the zone. Playing the 6'9" center with Baker playing in front of him. Baker, number 55, now slides in behind. Kling has the basketball. Baseline left off to Mason. Trying to work on the zone defense. Everett Stevens, his ball club up once. Derek Brown on the baseline to Mason. Drifts one step right back to Stevens. Top of the circle for two. Everett Stevens, 54-51. Evanston by three with 3:48 to go. The Rangers roar it up. Ty Nurnberger. Nurnberger looking low to Baker. They get it off. Weak side to Howe.
What a pass. I'll tell you, the playgrounds in Germany must be a lot like the playgrounds here in most urban areas in our country, because that kid sure knows how to play the game.
54-53. Wildcats by a point. Lewis Wolf off. No good. Tip by Clink. Baker on the board. And either Mason or Wool over his back. Let's see how they're going to call it.
I thought it was Clink.
I think it's Clink.
Yeah. Once again, we're going to see the inside power move, and from this point on, it's all power rebound. There are bodies all over the place on this one. And of course, the foul is that Kling. He got caught going over the top.
And on Mr. Kling, that's foul number three. He really hasn't had any foul problems at all in the second half. At the line will go Bruce Baker, 78% free throw shooter on the afternoon for Benton. He is 5 out of 8 at the line. 1-1. 54-53 Evanston.
Talk about the bottom line of rebounding is going after the ball eventually. They should do that.
Baker got the first one. We're dead even. 54-54. Take your pick with 3:24 left.
Take your pick.
One more throw to Bruce Baker. The Benton strong boy hits the second. The Rangers go up one. 55-54. Art Kimball, Ron Nikovich, and Frank Maslone with you. From the Assembly Hall. Quarterfinal round. Double-A state tournament. Everett Stevens for the Wildcats. To Tony Mason. Out front to Derek Brown. Back to Mason against his own defense. In the corner to Mason. Mason holding. Carlisle on him defensively. Brown with the penetration over Baker. Misses. Rebound lost. Ty Nurnberger with a chance to give the Rangers a three-point cushion, and he does.
Great body control, a contortionist.
Ty Nurnberger puts Fenton up by three, a 57-54.
And you see the tip-out rebound long to Nurnberger.
On the perimeter, Everett Stevens is on the outer iron, a clutch rebound. Big rebound, Carlisle. Football pass to Baker. Baker in against Mason. Can't get it. Gets his own rebound. Again misses it. Ball still loose. Deflected out of bounds. Going to belong to Benton. Well, what a fiercely fought struggle this is. 2:37 left.
We're really going to have to buy tickets for this.
There's the Evanston bench. And I think Herb Williams wants to calm everybody down. He's going to put in a reserve right now for Evanston. Brian Brown, 6'5", 170, a 16-year-old sophomore comes in, replacing an admittedly tired Lewis Wolf.
Art, I said to open this broadcast, welcome to the best prep basketball anywhere in the country. Serve it up.
If there's any better, I don't know where it would be.
I don't know where you'll find a better game than this.
Ty Nurnberger, well out on the floor. 57-54, Fenton by three. Rich Herron's ball club. Low, inside, Baker. Off the glass, and in. Power move by Bruce Baker. Rangers lead it by five. 59-54. Everett Stevens, fouled out front by House. Randy House picks up foul number three. Now, this is where coaches, of course, tend to get extremely nervous. You guys are a nervous breed anyway, Ron. Your occupation forces that.
Not really. There isn't any pressure here. Everything is cool.
You don't want fouls here if you're ahead. If you're behind, you definitely want to go to the line with that clock stopped. And at the free throw line is Everett Stevens. He's one out of two there this afternoon. 23 for Stevens. All-state guard, headed for Purdue. Free throw by Stevens. Good. 24 points for Everett Stevens. He has the bonus throw coming. 59-55. Fenton by four.
You know, and with two fat minutes to go yet, we've got plenty of time for yet another swing in the ballgame. Which direction it's going to swing, I don't know.
Well, we've had a spurt by both clubs in this quarter.
Sure did.
Second throw, Stevens for the Wildcats. Won't go. Rebound, baseline, controlled over there by Jay Schaefer, the sophomore center.
One thing's remained consistent, though, and that's been the Ranger rebounding.
Rangers bring it down. Darren Carlisle out front now to Nurnberger. And you may see Rich Herron's club become a bit more conservative now. They have the lead, 59-55 with 2 minutes to go. Ty Nurnberger out front. There's your rebounding edge, 39-27, fitting up 12 on the board.
It's increased consistently throughout the course of the ball game.
Derek Brown fouls, and now we're at the point the coaches talk about repeatedly. Free throw shooting ability with the chips on the line. Benton is a 68% free throw shooting ball club. They're going to be at the stripe right now. Evanston's got to stop the clock. The Wildcats are down four. And Ty Nurnberger will be at the stripe. And Frank Fassoni, this kid on the season, shoots him at an 82% clip.
This is Rich Herron's choice right here. You're Baker, and they got the ball in his hand.
You notice one thing about the Benton free throwers. They don't fool around at the line very much. Nurnberger and Baker both, two bounces, they fire away.
Nurnberger, an overachiever today. He's averaging 8.5 on the season. He's got 14. 61-55. Here's a jumper. Everett Stevens trying to bring the Wildcats back. Shot hung on the rim. Stevens gets it out of there. He's fouled. Everett Stevens trying to take charge. Darren Carlisle picks up his first foul on the loose ball with a minute and 42 seconds left to go. Stevens, one of the great players to play in the Assembly Hall on the prep level, I'd say, in recent years. No question about that.
No doubt about that. He's certainly shown everyone why he's a consensus All-Stater. And, of course, those people across that east-west line, you know, over in West Lafayette are happy to see what they're seeing here.
His club is down six with 1:42 to go. Stevens at the stripe. Won't go. On the rebound. And Lewis Wool, who just came back in the ballgame, is called for pushing off. That's his third.
Art, you're really right. Stevens has stunning skills. He's an explosive player with the ball. He's good defensively. He's got quick hands, nice range with his shot, no weakness in his game.
And I'm not sure we're seeing Stevens on a fantastic shooting day. I'm sure he's had days he's been hotter.
I imagine if he had the weakness, he might say it was his foul shooting. Although 65% is not terrible.
At the line is Jay Schaefer, 1-1 for the sophomore center from Benton. Missed it.
Rebound again.
Bruce Baker got it off the floor. Really more a recovery than a rebound. Knocked away by Stevens.
Steal.
Here is Stevens on the solo. Got it up and in. The basket's going to count, and he was fouled by Nurnberger. What a great play by Everett Stevens. He, of the electrifying skill, spiked the basketball when three-quarter court, 61-57. Evanston back within four, and Ron, this game is not over.
It certainly isn't, and that was Stevens' second steal within seconds. And, of course, as you earlier said, he's trying to take over. He has the skills to take over. We remarked with about 2 minutes and 19 seconds ago that there's still time for the game to swing, and it still can't swing because he's going to the line with a minute and a half to go or so with a chance to pull his club within two. Right now, we're looking at a very critical free throw, obviously.
All right, he got the bucket, trying to complete the three-point play. 61-57, bitten by four. It was noisier than I've heard the assembly hall in a long, long time. Stevens got it. Big, big three-point play. 61-58. Three-point lead to Benton. The Rangers, of course, being picked up all over the place. Here's a double
steal. Third
steal.
Stevens
got it. He's on
the bucket.
Over Stevens, and immediately, Rich Herron desperately wants a timeout. It's a one-point ball game.
Well, there's his third steal within seconds. You know, he reminds us of Bruce Douglas, doesn't he?
Exactly.
A minute and 23 seconds left to go in the ball game. And here we are at the Assembly Hall, 61-60. Benton, Rich Herron wants the timeout, and Frank, I'm going to take a breather.
John Deere Country Companies Insurance and DeKalb Pfizer Genetics are happy to again be presenting this exciting tournament action. We hope you're enjoying our coverage. Don't forget, tonight, another quarterfinal session, and then again tomorrow at the semifinals and the championship. I think we may have all kinds of games like this.
Everett Stevens has 29 points, and of the 29 points, he's tossed 12 of them in the final period, and I would say, what, 10 of the 12 in the last 3 minutes?
You know, and early on we talked about the key to both games being the performance of each team's respective superstar, and we certainly haven't been disappointed in any respect in that regard.
Of course, Evanston is undefeated, and here are the teams that have won the state championship with unblemished records. But still a tough assignment. What do you tell me, Ron? There are 13 of them or 14?
I think they're a total of 13 now, right.
And of course, your own ball club in 1970 at Lyons Township was among them.
We were number six in that hit parade.
All right, look at the time. A minute and 23. The score. There's the whole story for you on the screen.
The Plainsboro Art was the 13th.
Okay. Little pickpocket defense for Evanston. They're all over the floor. They're down a point. Benton with the basketball. Heavy traffic. Kai Nurnberger brings it across. A minute and 18 showing.
Another steal.
A steal taken away by Mike Cobb. Cobb's so low. He scores. I don't think the bucket's going to count.
That foul on the floor.
Ty Nurnberger commits the personal. Nurnberger picks up his fourth foul. At the line is going to be Mike Cobb, who is non-starter. Cobb with his first free throw attempt of the evening.
He's a 62% free throw shooter.
Shouldn't say evening, should say afternoon.
Well, we see the fourth steal by Evanston within, well, recent minutes or seconds for that matter, which has been very critical. And of course, ever since that 2 minute and 19 second mark, we've seen a turn again. And the free throws become critical, obviously.
Mike Cobb can tie it right here. He does.
We talk about free throw percentages, but of course it's that free throw percentage under 2 minutes. That really counts, doesn't it?
The pressure is dripping in the assembly hall. Cobb, a reserve, can give Evanston the lead.
It's a thumper.
Second toss. Iron, no good. Rebound, Bruce Baker. Baker, the 6'7" All-Stater, hauls it down for Benton, but we're tied now with a minute and four to go. Up quickly, the Rangers. Baker to Shaver. Shaver shot rolls out. No good. Rebound, Everett Stevens for Evanston. Here's Stevens roaring down. Well out on the floor. Everett Stevens with the left-handed dribble. And let's see what they're going to do. Herb Williams going to play it for one, I think, with 45 seconds left.
Well, Art used the word maybe, Frank.
Maybe.
We're tied.
Maybe eight more minutes as the fourth quarter began.
The clock ticking steadily down. Evanston with the basketball, 61-61. Half a minute. Evanston has a timeout to play with. They could run it down and then call it. Derek Brown, this is Mason. Cobb out front. Where's Everett Stevens? Stevens swings in the left quarter. You can't see him on the screen right now.
He'll pop in.
Now timeout.
Down to 10 seconds, and here's the timeout taken by the Wildcats. Evanston takes the timeout. 10 seconds, all that we have remaining in this one in regulation. All right, Ron Nikovich, the situation, you've been in it many, many times. You've got the basketball.
The key thing is inbounding it, first of all, which I think they'll be able to do because I don't think that Benton is going to come out of their zone in the thing. But I do think that if they're going to win in regulation time, it'll come as a result of something obvious. It'll be an outside shot penetrating the seam of the defense. And if there's a miracle, it'll be the offensive rebound, which they have not had all game long.
There's our IHSA network. As you see, Rich Herron, the Benton coach, diligently talking. Ron, the pressure is on the D. There's no question about that.
Yeah, and of course, the fact that they've been in a zone defense all ball game long, of course, they're going to have to, as we say, point the defense. In other words, point your defense to a potential receiver or shooter, and you've got to be there to challenge that shot, and you've got to crash that board to prevent the miracle offensive tip and rebound.
Obviously, Everett Stevens is going to be a marked man, whatever Benton does defensively here in the final 10 seconds. He has been unbelievable in the fourth quarter.
He's a great player.
All right, Evanston will inbound. 10 ticks of the clock remaining in regulation. Deadlocked at 61. Lewis Wool will pull the trigger on the inbound pass. Evanston won the state title in 68. Okay. Everett Stevens to Cobb in the corner. Back to Cobb. Cobb's jumper is short. Benton with the rebound. That's not going to be enough. We're out of time, and we're in overtime. Actually, Cobb got up a shot. It was short. It became an air ball. The rebound effort, Benton really didn't get a crack at it. And so, fellas, at the end of regulation, here we are, deadlocked at 61-61, and one of your network sponsors, Country Companies Insurance.
When Ed moved to Wheaton, he thought he was going to have to look high and low for a Country Companies Auto Claim Center. He didn't know that Country Companies has more of them than anyone else in the state. So how about it, Ed? Hard to find?
Nope. It's just 5 minutes from my house. And the Country Companies folks around here are just as friendly.
You've got the country behind you.
For the most auto claim centers.
You've got the country companies.
E.T.'s on a roll with a look at Richard Benjamin's new film, Racing with the Moon, starring Sean Penn and Elizabeth McGovern.
Oh, that's great.
Then, Suzanne Plachette's making news on TV's Comedy Beat as reporter Maggie Brigg.
Plus, Pamela Sue Martin starts a dynasty of her own with the premiere of her new film, Torchlight.
And Queen tunes in a hit with Radio Gaga.
And what's your...
All coming your way on the next Entertainment Tonight.
About set to get underway. Benton and Evanston deadlock 61-61. Everett Stevens with a spectacular final stanza for Evanston. He had a 12-point quarter out of his team's 21. They outscored Benton 21-18 to set up the OT. Frank?
I think we should point out for people that watch a lot of college basketball, overtime is 3 minutes in high school, not five. 3 minutes.
Okay, it's Everett Stevens jumping against Jay Schaefer. All batted in the air. Kling picks it up. Of course, Stevens
almost had that same situation.
Stevens couldn't handle his own tip there, and he was the closest guy to the basketball. Here are the Wildcats. Derek Brown, Mason Brown against the Benton zone. Everett Stevens back to Brown. Kling trying to post up with Baker in behind, and Stevens on the penetration. He got it.
That's one of the few baskets they've had on a swing around to the right side of the court because they seem to overload the left side of the court and keep it there too long. If they swing it around to the right side, that easy shot will materialize. We'll probably see more of that throughout the course of this overtime.
63-61, Evanston by two. The Benton Rangers, Kai Nurnberger, left corner. Out front to House on the left wing. The lob to Baker. Right back to Nurnberger, puts up the perimeter jumper. Won't go. Rebound, Kling. Steve Kling for Evanston.
Kling has been steady.
Indeed he has. The Wildcats with the basketball and a two-point lead.
Well,
a hard-earned two-point lead in a game that has had all sorts of ebbs and flows, hills and valleys, spurts by both clubs. Tony Mason to Derek Brown. Ty Nurnberger moves out toward him. Benton almost forced into a man-to-man alignment right now. They can't afford to settle back in that zone trailing here in overtime. Here's the penetration. Stevens on a good dish off to Kling for the bucket. Pretty play.
The basket and the assist. Credit the 4 points to Stevens one way or another so far.
Evanston 65, Benton 61 in overtime in the overtime period. Holding high. House. House works in the corner. Now he's He's going to take the perimeter shot and got it. Randy Howes, and Benton's going to have to do that a little bit because, of course, Evanston will pack it in now. 65-63. 2-point lead to the Wildcats. There's a double team at the timeline. Derek Brown breaks it. Everett Stevens loses the basketball. Hi, Nurnberger. Notice Nurnberger reaching from behind. Lead pass to Bruce Baker. Let him too far, and becomes a turnover. Benton had the break, but threw it away.
The Benton defense is extending itself now.
Okay, after regulation, it was Benton 24 of 54 from the field, shooting 44%. Evanston 26 out of 61, shooting 42%. Free throws, 9 of 18 for Evanston, 13 of 20 for Benton. Rebounding, 46-27 Benton. Benton with 10 more turnovers now, 18-8. Baker gambles on the steal, can't get it. And here is a foul on Dave Peters of Benton as the ball went to Tony Mason.
Well, the turnovers, of course, have negated to an extent the what has now become an overwhelming rebounding advantage for Benton, but you never know it by the score.
No. Mike Todd checks out, and back in comes Steve Poing. Poing is back in the center circle right now. He's not under the board at all. Everett Stevens and Lewis Wool are, along with Derek Brown and Tony Mason, is at the free throw line in a one-and-one situation. 2-point lead to Evanston. Big, big free throws. We're in overtime. 54 seconds left in OT. Mason misses it. Benton with a chance to tie. Rebound controlled by Jay Schaefer. Schaefer to Kai Nurnberger. Nurnberger off to Dave Peters. Here's Peters off between the circles. Down to 41 seconds in this one.
They're looking inside.
Peters being covered by Wool cross court.
Skip pass against the man-to-man defense. That's emergency time.
2-point lead for Evanston at 65-63. Nurnberger to Schaefer, to Peters, to Baker. Power move. Great block.
Who got the
block?
Great
block by Everett Stevens.
Who got the block?
Stevens skied with 20 seconds left. Evanston with the ball and the 2-point lead.
In overtime,
on Peters.
In overtime, we've seen a basket, an assist, and a key block by Stevens. Now, I don't know how much more this guy's going to do.
That's all for David Peters in the foul column. I think he's picked up number 5. He did. Peters fouls out with 16 seconds left, and Rich Heron wanted a foul call on the inside. On that block by Stevens, he did not get it. And as a result, Evanston's going to have a man at the free throw line. Evanston 65, Benton 63. 16 seconds left in the overtime period.
You talk about a thoroughbred, Art. That Everett Stevens is some kind of basketball player, and it's exciting to watch him do everything, defense and offense, and the some kind he is superb. John Deere, Country Companies Insurance, and DeKalb Pfizer Genetics are happy to again be presenting this tournament action. We hope you enjoy it, and don't forget, join us tonight. We'll all be on at 7, and again tomorrow for the semifinals and the championship of AA.
Everett Stevens now with 31 points for Evanston this afternoon. And he will be at the line. His club is up 2 with 16 seconds left. That block shot on the inside a moment ago was the big, big play of this overtime.
Big play of the game.
Right. Stevens 1-1. His club leads it by 2. Note the concentration, the deep breath. There you see the time. Missed it. Bruce Baker with a big rebound. All right, here's Benton with a chance to tie. The Rangers bring it up quickly. Left side is Howes out front now. Long jumper by Howes. No good. Rebound, Stevens. And that's going to seal it. Evanston has survived by 2. And again, the great rebound by Everett Stevens, who came on. And certainly, if there's any question about his superstar status, he completely erased it. Look at the crowd on the floor for Evanston. The keenly disappointed Benton Ball Club. Two tremendously game basketball teams. And a real overtime thriller here at the Assembly Hall in Champaign. Evanston justifiably delighted as Herb Williams hurdles the quarterfinal round. And a heartbreaking loss for Rich Heron and his Benton Rangers. Two teams that displayed tremendously. There is Rich Heron going over to shake hands with Herb Williams. And what a battle this was.
A great game, Art, and I think it may, as we look back on it, probably we can look to the many times that Evanston has undergone this kind of thing. People have felt that for an undefeated team that perhaps they aren't as impressive as an undefeated team ought to be. However, since the tournament trail began, they've found a way, one way or another, typically in Everett Stevens, to pull it out.
They win. All right, the ball game is history. Evanston stays alive, and there is a very disappointed Rich Heron walking away from the bench over to shake hands with Herb Williams. One of your network sponsors, DeKalb, the Pfizer Genetics.
What we've got here is one heck of a good corn crop. Oh, it's too early to start counting the cash. You know that. Because there's a lot of things that have to go right between now and harvest. But it sure helps to know this T1100 is as good a corn as you are a corn grower. If you want good yields this fall, you got to start this spring with T1100. I am.
I'm Ted Koppel. Every weeknight on Nightline, we try to bring people together who are worlds apart to let them present their side on important issues and events. What happens can be enlightening, it can be exciting, and it could be one of those unique live moments that you won't see anywhere else. So watch Nightline weeknights at 10:30 following News Center 3 at 10 with Nancy Pierce here on TV3 in the Tri-State.
For an encore in a game like this, Ron Nikovich, but you know you're going to have a flock of great ball games down here, and this may have just set the tone. The brilliant performance of Everett Stevens, the All-Stater, 31 points, led Evanston. Taking a look at other scoring for the Wildcats, Lewis Wool had 7, Tony Mason was 6, Steve Kling scored 4, Derek Brown with a total of 12 points here this afternoon, and Mike Cobb came in, scored a single point. Kevin Ackles played in the first half, picked up a fielder for 2, and also Francois Jean Paul also had 2. So Evanston, far and away, the scoring leader was Everett Stevens with a brilliant 31-point performance. For the Benton Rangers, Bruce Baker with 12, 21, 25 for Mr. Baker. Randy House winds up with a total of 8. And Jay Schaefer finishes with 4. Kai Nurnberger, their brilliant guard, the exchange student from West Germany, had 14 points, Ron. Big performance for him. Darren Carlisle ends up with 6, and 6 points for David Peters off the bench.
I thought Nurnberger, as a point guard, showed that he could do a lot of things. He has speed and quickness. He's got great body control, can shoot the ball, can run an offense.
You know, for a moment, well. I happen to think of this, didn't have a chance to mention it during the play-by-play, but had the game gone the other way, a two-point Benton win instead of a two-point Evanston win, remember the shot at the half.
Oh,
Nurnberger threw it in. Yeah, one step inside the 10-second line.
Yeah, that was a great shot. And of course, it was the kind of shot that, you know, you'd think would propel them into a early great start in the third quarter, but it was a game of spurts. Each team had their opportunities, and the clock ran out.
Shooting real quickly, it was Evanston 28 of 63, 44%. Benton shot 43% on 25 of 58. Frank Fasoni standing by with a guest, and let's bring you now to Frank Fasoni.
Thank you very much, Art. I'm with Ron Ashley, the head basketball coach at Mount Prospect. And Ron knows a little bit about how Rich Heron of Benton is feeling right now, because in the sectional, Evanston beat Mount Prospect 76-74. And once again, Ron, it was a little bit of Everett Stevens.
He's a tremendous ball player. He does it all. He handles the ball well. He penetrates. He can shoot. He rebounds. Block shot. Just a total ball player.
How did the game develop and end between your team, Mount Prospect, and Evanston?
Well, we led Evanston for about 3.5 quarters. And then with about 2 minutes to go in the ball game, it was tied 74-74. And then Evanston called the timeout with 1:09, milked the clock down to 9 seconds, and then Stevens beat us with 3 seconds to go with about a 20-foot jumper.
What was your reaction to this game, and particularly with and the way Benton played?
Well, I thought Benton did an outstanding job. I thought they were very patient. They moved the ball well. They played good defense. But I think the overall quickness of Evanston was just a little bit too much for them to overcome.
They have this ability, it seems, to just keep winning, do whatever it takes to win.
It's amazing. From the regional, the sectional, the super sectional, they win. They play just well enough to win. But I think that's a sign of an outstanding ball club, and they just keep winning.
And they have some place to go when the going gets tough, and they go to their man, Everett Stevens.
He sure is. He's an outstanding basketball player, and he's headed for Purdue, and I think they have an outstanding one.
I know Gene Cady's very happy.
Speaking of outstanding, St. Joseph's of Westchester and Harvey Thornton coming up. You know both teams. What do you think about this game?
Well, I think it's going to be determined with the guards. You know, St. Joe has two outstanding guards in Robert Early and Tony Freeman, and the same with Thornton. I think, and then naturally the big man inside for Thornton, but I think the guard play is going to dictate the eventual outcome.
What do you think about the tempo of the game now? Does St. Joe like to get up and down the floor?
Yes, they do. They want to get going in an up-tempo game. They'll play a man-to-man, tough man-to-man defense. Gene's been known for that throughout his history at St. Joe's, and I think it's going to be in a very aggressive ball game.
Yeah, I imagine they'll have to do some sinking on that big Darren Guest at 6'9".
They sure are. He's a ton inside. When he wants to play, he can do everything.
Do you think there's a favorite now in the tournament?
No, I think it's up for grabs. I think everybody down here, I think, is capable of winning.
Ron Ashley, Mount Prospect, thanks for coming by. Congratulations on a wonderful year.
Thank you very much.
For a great basketball season, we're all proud of you. Your hard work really paid off, and the Benton Boosters want to say thanks. Sutu Clothing Store, Mine Wells Incorporated, H2O, Western Auto, and Wisely's Menswear. You're not alone, Rangers. We're behind you all the way.